following is a special presentation of ESPN on ABC. The State Fair of Texas provides a background for our quarterback showdown. Colt McCoy of Texas, this young man can beat you with his arm or his legs. Oklahoma's Sam Bradford, he has been a symphony of quarterbacking efficiency for the Sooners. Who's the best today? You gotta think big to understand it. You gotta look long and hard to take it all in. Two schools with larger than life legacies. The rivalry, brewed over so long a time, is always intense. But never more so than when title hopes are at stake. And that's just what we have today. From the great states of Oklahoma and Texas, come two teams ready to lay it all on the line. For pride and to keep the dream alive. Time to pick your color. Oklahoma Crimson or Texas Orange. This one's big. In Dallas, for over a century, Oklahoma and Texas have waged one of the fiercest rivalries in college football. Today's classic on ABC is presented by Best Buy. It is the 103rd matchup of the Red River rivalry as number 5 Texas and number 1 Oklahoma meet in a game where bragging rights are just the beginning. 92,000 split right down the middle. The AP Top 5 tells you the story. Not only taking dead aim at a Big 12 title, but also a national championship. That's how high the stakes are here today. Now, let's go down to the sideline. Chris Fowler and the gang standing by. Chris?
Brent, great to be with you. Crimson burn orange under beautiful blue skies. Neither team, neither offense, neither quarterback's really been challenged so far. They've been so dominant. For both defenses are aggressive. Bradford and McCoy have weapons to work with, but who's going to have the time to work with?
That's the big thing here is the adversity. Neither quarterback has faced any adversity at all, and they both will at some point, you would think, in this football game. Sam Bradford, to me, at this point, the way he's executing, the talent that he has around him, the offensive line, is his playing his way as well as any quarterback in college football. The challenge is on Colt McCoy. Accounts for 68% of the Longhorns' offense. He leads them in rushing. He's completing 79% of his passes. He's got to have one of those games that he'll go into the annals as a great Texas quarterback. So Colt McCoy, for the Horns to win, has got to raise the bar here and really challenge this Oklahoma defense.
It was an emotional speech he made in the locker room after defeat last year that really turned the corner in terms of leadership for Colt McCoy and his team. You compare the coaches, it was Bob Stoops who turned around the fortunes in this rivalry when he arrived at Oklahoma. But Mac Brown's gotten him 2 out of the last 3 years.
And Chris, you know, and as a former coach, I love to say this about these guys. As good a football coach as they are, they're even better human beings. They represent the College Football Coaches Association like you should be, honest with unquestioned integrity. Stoops has a chance, as young as he is, maybe to catch Bowden or Paterno, maybe, if he stays in it. And all Brown has done is had 10 straight 9-win seasons. I mean, those are two great human beings, plus wonderful coaches.
At the top of the game. It used to be kind of frosty between them, I think, when Bob first got it. Now it's friendly, and you can think. You're thinking long-term future. Bob Stoops.
Exactly.
Catching Bobby and Joe.
He's
just worried about running it out of here with one win here. Now we'll find out which team can manage all the emotion, can avoid the big mistakes, and handle that first adversity, because the adversity is about to begin for somebody in a few minutes. ESPN's presentation of college football on ABC is going to return right after this as the Sooners take the field. OU and Texas in a classic. Coming up live after a word from our ABC stations.
Well, Norman, Oklahoma, and Austin, Texas have come to the Cotton Bowl. First began playing back in 1900, and they moved this game to Dallas in 1912 and permanently in 1929. For Bob Stoops, it's a little bit shorter. to the Cotton Bowl, but not by much. Dallas equidistant almost. 7-mile difference that Mack Brown had to travel. The Texas coach is standing by with Lisa Salters. Let's go to Lisa.
Thanks a lot, Brent. Mac, Colt McCoy comes into this game with a 79% pass completion rate. What's going to be the key for him to have that kind of success today against the Sooners?
Lisa, we've got to have great protection. Bob's a great defensive coach. They put a tremendous amount of pressure on quarterbacks throughout the year. If we can protect up front, the way Colt's throwing, he can throw it against anybody.
Now, Oklahoma, I know you don't want to hear this. They've outscored their opponents 103-3 in the first quarter. All eyes are going to be on your young secondary. What do you need to see from those guys?
We've given up 9 points, 3 field goals in the first quarter, so we know OU's great on offense. We believe in our defense.
Stat for stat, I like that. Good luck to you, Coach.
Thanks, Lisa.
Brent?
All right, Lisa, and Oklahoma will get the first possession as Texas won the toss and deferred. And Bob Stoops versus Mack Brown is 6-3 overall. Kirk Herbstreit just set the record for arriving in the broadcast booth, getting up from the field. So, Kirk, I know you guys have talked about these quarterbacks all along. That's their total yards, remember, rushing as well as passing. Touchdowns, even though Bradford not known for his running, he has scored a couple rushing, and each of them tossed 3 interceptions.
Both playing as well as anybody, not only in their own conference where quarterback play is exceptional, but in the entire nation. And, of course, both will be in the spotlight today for these two offenses.
What a beautiful day.
Just perfect.
This is one of the great scenes, folks. If you like to make your way around classics in college football, make sure you attend one of the Red River Rivalry. I noticed with the Lee Corso, he didn't get the memo. It's no longer the Red River Shootout.
Exactly. Okay. Boom. End of the show there. He scared me to death with it.
I know he did. Iglesias and Murray. A couple of OU's great athletes are back, and Justin Tucker with the ball on the tee for the Horns. Now, let the good times roll. Going to come out on the 20-yard line. There are so many impact players in college football today is presented by Best Buy, and let's take a look at some of them.
Well, we decided to go with four, and we're going to start in the backfield with DeMarco Murray. Has been battling back with the knee. We'll see if he's healthy enough to be a factor today. Manuel Johnson, number one. Keep an eye on him. He's been a go-to guy. Joaquin Iglesias, number nine on the other side. Also very talented and ability to get downfield. And a tight end, Jermaine Grisham. Big, strong, arguably the most talented and most athletic tight end in college football.
Bradford, not much heat on him, and he throws in underneath and completes the first pass to Jermaine Grisham. And that, of course, is perhaps the most talented tight end. They flex him off the line, and Bradford will go to him, and he starts off the game with a completion.
Kevin Wilson, the offensive coordinator from Oklahoma, has implemented this new no huddle. It's high octane. They really get up to the line of scrimmage and challenge you defensively. Sometimes, as in this case, they'll look over for confirmation, as we see throughout the country. But you'll see as this game goes on, the speed of this offense is really second to none.
Murray is the deep set tailback. Busts his way for the first down. There's a penalty flag on the play.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense number 37. 15-yard penalty for the end run. Automatic first down.
Henry Melton, the converted running back, defensive end, guilty of the face mask violation.
This Texas defense, of course, knows that they have to streamline the playbook because of the speed of Sam Bradford, and they have to be able to penetrate. Will Muschamp, the defensive coordinator, one of the best in the country, was brought in by Mack Brown with this type of game, and he said he's going to cut back on a lot of the plays just to get lined up and play fast, but you can't make mistakes like that.
5 yards shy of midfield. Comes back with Murray on a run, and he's thrown for a loss. And at that time, the defense led by Jared Norton, who took over as a starting middle linebacker last week. And Muschamp told us that he would probably come back with Norton instead of Bobbino as his starter.
Probably the best group of linebackers, Brent, that Texas has had in a number of years.
Fake the end around, dump it off to Murray in a foot race with a linebacker, and he is deep into Texas territory. Gideon, the young defensive back, but that's a 34-yard gain before Gideon could get a hand on it.
Well, the fake to Murray and then the end around slowed Texas just enough and created some confusion with McElroy, the linebacker 38, who was supposed to be trailing and following. He gets lost in the confusion there, and the slight hesitation gives DeMarco Murray room.
And they don't take much time, do they, as they drop it back off to Gresham. That's his second reception. So Gresham takes it down to the 5-yard line, where it will be first and goal, and that means probably that Brown will come in. Chris Brown, he scored 6 touchdowns for the Sooners, and he'll come in there at tailback.
Getting these first downs, very important to create that rhythm.
They'll try Brown first, and Texas was ready. They might want to try to put some pressure on the boundary and roll Bradford. He's not known for his running ability, but he's scored a couple of times. That, of course, is the impressive stat that Lisa Salters asked Mac Brown about. 103-3 in the first quarter. Kirk, that's unbelievable.
Well, I don't know if we've seen a stat like that in college football. 103-3, and they demoralize their opponent in the first quarter before they can adjust and think they have a chance in the game.
We can't throw for it. No pressure. Almost intercepted. A great play by Earl Thomas, number 12. Earl Thomas did a great job of jumping that play.
He's a safety, and he's out there in one-on-one coverage against the one of the most gifted receivers in the Big 12, Emmanuel Johnson. Not only did he hold his own, he almost stepped in front of that Bradford throw and went 98 yards the other way.
Gresham, you'll note, is flexed off to the right. He's had 2 receptions already. Bradford, though, pumps left. Now comes back. Touchdown, Oklahoma. Emmanuel Johnson, after being denied on the right side of the offense, scores on the left.
The pump fake to the inside, caught the corner, Ryan Palmer out of position, just a little bit with the shoulders by the quarterback Bradford. Johnson moved from the inside to the outside, got the leverage that he needed, and that's a touchdown.
That was close when the knee went down. That was very, very close. Instant replay obviously confirmed that it was a touchdown all the way, and Jimmy Stevens taps on the extra point.
110-3.
Wow. Texas turn next, folks. We welcome you back to the Cotton Bowl, and just perhaps Oklahoma got away with one on that third down. Let's take a close look. Watch the knee. Was it down shy of the end zone?
The knee is definitely down. It's tough to see where the ball is, but the ball looks short as well. That would have, by the way, set up a fourth down.
I can't believe that instant replay didn't stop the extra point and take a look at that. Regardless, they would have had one more shot at it. So here we go. Now it is Texas' turn. Fielded at the 15 by Cosby, the wide receiver. Got a gap. This is the one weakness in the Oklahoma armor. They have not covered kicks well this year. Now, how about our impact players brought to you by Best Buy here?
Well, we're going to start in the backfield. You'll see a number of backs, but Chris, you might want to help me here. Obanaya, well, number 3 will be a guy they got to get the football to. Very intelligent player, Quan Cosby, number 6. Favorite target at this point of Colt McCoy, has big playability. And then, of course, Jordan Shipley on the other side, number 8, also an explosive receiver. They'll try to move him around and at times put him in a slot for matchups.
Diving reception comes right on back to Quan Cosby, who returned the kick, and here is number 12.
Colt McCoy.
79%. That's tough to do against air. 79% of your passes, but he has been, at this point, flawless with his ability to make reads. That's what they say is different this year with Colt McCoy from last year. He's getting more protection, but he's processing the information and making very good decisions.
Obanaya dances back and is thrown down by Ryan Reynolds, who leads this team. Came into the game with 43 tackles. He's now up to 44.
With this defense, as aggressive as Oklahoma is, after that opening drive by their own offense, I think it's early in this game important for Texas, who hasn't faced a lot of adversity, to be able to have some execution and have some success to get themselves to believe that they can move the ball against this aggressive defense.
Here's third and four. Oklahoma jumped. There's the penalty call. McCoy will go down, but let's wait now for the penalty to be assessed. It looked like Oklahoma jumped the gun in that. We'll wait and see here. Remember, this was a third and four. And that's a first down.
With the 5-yard penalty, there's a first down.
So, Big Gerald McCoy, who has been a load to handle in the middle of that defensive line, and there's Brent Venables, the five. We got two outstanding defense. Matter of fact, we got two outstanding coaching staffs. Now, John Childs, the backup quarterback, is off to McCoy's right. Option, and he can throw or run. Childs got no more than a yard on first down. And, Kirk, let's take a look at today's X Factor brought to you by City.
I think if you look on both sides of the football, obviously there's going to be different keys. You start with Texas. On defense, they've got to be able to pressure Sam Bradford. They've got to get pressure with four, as we saw in the first series. They were unable to do that. And then for Oklahoma, we saw tempo, tempo, tempo. The more first downs they're able to create, the quicker you'll see them get up to the line of scrimmage to try to put that Texas defense on their heels.
Play fake. Down the middle, complete. There is that high percentage completion rate, and he hits Jordan Shipley, the senior, his first reception.
The play fake, Brent, that you indicated, I think throws the linebackers just enough. Travis Lewis gets stuck in there, and also the leader, Ryan Reynolds, by slowing them down and creating a bit of a confusion, a nice little window right between the two linebackers, and again, there's the accuracy from Colt.
And this time he does hand it off to Obanaya, and he is brought down by Reynolds. Obanaya is an outstanding receiver, folks. He could come out. They'll even, as they stretch the field, motion him out and line him up in a slot. Second and seven, jump ball, diving catch, and a penalty flag. But what a catch by Cosby.
Be interested to see if they caught Cosby for pushing off there or if they're going to get Oklahoma. There was a lot of contact there.
Pass interference. Defense number two. Penalty decline. Result of the play. First down.
So the corner, Brian Jackson, commits the foul, and that will give Texas, boy, you blink and these guys are attacking for big gains.
Ability here by Cosby to lay out and extend himself parallel and make the catch. Former baseball player showing he knows how to get out there at center field and make the catch in the gap.
Now here's your first and goal now for McCoy. Looks like movement in the middle. I don't see a flag yet. Here comes Obanaya, battling hard, running well to the 3-yard line. No, he's going to be marked down at the 7. I see the umpire jumping in to mark that the knee grazed the ground back there.
Right now, Mack Brown and Greg Davis, the offensive coordinator, doing a great job on this opening drive of mixing up the looks, making the Oklahoma defense think and showing some different things that they have not been able to show maybe early in the year. There's Greg Davis, the offensive coordinator. A great attack here, again, in this opening drive. Now we'll see if their red zone success continues.
Yeah. read beautifully by the defense that time. Keenan Clayton, a safety, he was moved to that linebacking spot, and 22 was all over this play.
When they get in this area, they have had a lot of success, but they have not faced defenses like this, and Keenan Clayton closing in on those wide receivers.
Defensive call's been signaled in. Reynolds passing the ball to Keenan. Here's your third and goal now. McCoy in trouble. Big Gerald McCoy, 6'4", 295, Oklahoma City.
And give an assist here to the coverage. The secondary and linebackers taking away all of Colt McCoy's options. And by doing that, eventually, you know the front four from Oklahoma is going to cave in and get to Colt McCoy.
Hunter Lawrence. Perfect so far this year. This will be a 26-yard attempt. So, Oklahoma's first possession results in a touchdown. Texas answers, but only with a field goal. Oklahoma leading Texas 7-3. Ball on the tee again for Tucker. Blew off. So we'll do it all over. And so let me remind you that this Sunday night, for all the teachers who have made a difference in our lives, comes a makeover that will proudly pay one of them back. An inspiring all-new Extreme Makeover Home Edition Sunday, 8, 7 Central on ABC. The State Fair of Texas. Folks, if you can fry it, you can find it here.
Oh, my gosh. They fry everything.
You have yourself a corny dog?
Not yet.
I was here with a producer once, Bob Goodrich, I swear. 12 to 14. Fielded at the 5. Iglesias, the wide receiver, picks his way out to the 25-yard line.
You know, Sam Bradford, we've touched on him a lot, but his intelligence is, I think, the thing that has allowed him to become the quarterback that he is. He's, of course, you see his numbers. You, when you're a quarterback and you run a hurry-up offense, it's one thing to hurry everybody in the line of scrimmage, but you've got to remain calm as far as the way you process information, the defenses that you're reading. And that's what he does such a good job of, and he just happens to have outstanding footwork, a quick release, and an accurate and strong arm. The total package.
Coming back with Murray. No more than a yard because of the defense by Lamar Houston.
I've been very impressed here. I know they gave up a big play to DeMarco Murray and eventually a touchdown. But I can see already, early in this game, Texas is sticking to their guns as far as who they are with Will Muschamp. Aggressive, attacking, in your face. You're going to give up some plays, but you're going to make some plays. But at least they're trying to be the aggressor on defense.
Sam Bradford managing the offense from under center off a play fake. No pressure, rolling right. Receivers were covered, Kirk, and he had to haul it out of bounds.
Good coverage downfield, and this front four prides itself on trying to get pressure, but much like we saw from Oklahoma's secondary, when you have good coverage like that, the speed that these two defenses have in the front four, quarterback's not going to have much time to throw the ball.
Third and 9. You saw number 98, Arakpo. He is one of the best in the college game. Can he get to the OU quarterback? And now it's 3rd and 9. Kevin Wilson changes it up. In underneath, well short of the first down. Iglesias, not even close. Brown with the coverage.
You mentioned the play. They changed the play, but what was interesting is Texas also changed the play from Will Muschamp. A lot of times you see quarterbacks look over for confirmation. He looked over, changed his play, and Will Muschamp said, okay, if you're going to do that, we're going to change our play as well.
Some adjustments there, Kirk. That's three and out now.
Yep.
This time after that very efficient touchdown. So Mike Knoll will be punting with Cosby back deep. Pressure. Is there going to be a penalty flag? There is a flag. Knoll did a sensational job under pressure of getting that punt off. Remember, it was fourth and nine now. Because it was nine, that's why they declined the penalty. The penalty would not have given them a first down, but it was close, and you could see all kinds of heat coming.
Top of the screen, they said four, but it was actually number three there. It looked like he got in. Boy, a close call.
And Jonathan Nelson was in on top of him, and folks, you're watching ESPN College Football on ABC. We welcome you back to the Red River Rivalry. Oklahoma 7, Texas 3. After a three and out, now it's Colt McCoy and the Longhorns coming up on their own 39-yard line. On first down, under pressure, forced out of the pocket and has to throw on the run and was not accurate that time. Let's go down below to Lisa.
Well, Brent, as you know, Colt McCoy is still very close to his predecessor, Vince Young. He said they usually text throughout the week. But yesterday morning, Vince Young called Colt McCoy, and he gave him some advice. He said, look, it's your job with everything that goes on surrounding this game. It's your job to keep the team calm and relaxed, not just during the game, but leading up to the game as well. Brent?
Second and 10 for McCoy and the Horns. Three down, blitzer from the outside. McCoy in trouble again to the right side. Throws for a first down to Cosby. What a fine throw on the move. This, of course, had Brent Venables concerned. On the move, he said, Colt McCoy is still a very dangerous thrower.
Well, it's one-on-one here, and it's an ability to have Colt McCoy get away from the pressure. And a rare blitz, Oklahoma, these first two plays here on this series, they blitz twice, which you don't see a lot from Oklahoma's defense. But the one-on-one matchup that time goes in favor of Cosby, matched up against Brian Jackson.
McCoy wraps it up. So on a missed handoff to Obanaya, ball on the ground, and the quarterback recovers.
Sometimes with option football, when you're making a read on the backside end, there's a little bit of confusion. Am I pulling it or am I giving it? And anytime you have just a slight bit of hesitation from the back of the quarterback, sometimes you see the ball go down on the ground. The Longhorns fortunate there to recover that.
Five receivers on second and 13. Screen. Not much doing because of Nick Harris. The safety read it beautifully and made the stop. We go to Matt Weiner in New York for an update. It is Oklahoma 7, Texas 3. Third and 9 for the Longhorns. They show pressure. Bust through on McCoy, who's on the move. Breaks free and turns it into a gain before Jackson can make the tackle. That shows you his ability to scramble out of trouble.
Ability and courage. I think Oklahoma was offsides on a play. It looked like it. The defensive end may have jumped. But instead of going out of bounds, Colt McCoy said,
defense number 44, 5-yard penalty, repeat third down.
That's Jeremy Beal.
The speed is one thing, but when Oklahoma's defense, one of the nastiest defenses in the country, is closing in on you, you'd think a veteran quarterback, third time he's played in this rivalry, he said, bring it on. You got to be careful with those shoulders, Colt.
Travis Lewis. Couldn't wrestle him down. Major Applewhite, you can see him, one of the signalers over there. One's hot, one's cold, in case anybody's trying to steal it.
Texas has not shown this look very often at all. The empty with five wide receivers set.
Third and four with three down in the defensive front. And they move a backer into the gap, and it's a four-man rush. McCoy deflected, incomplete. Obanaya, the running back, was the intended receiver, and it was Keenan Clayton who got a hand on it.
Well, Keenan Clayton moved from safety to linebacker in the spring, and because in the Big 12, so many of these offenses are spread offenses, he's kind of like a linebacker, but really plays as a safety because he's out in coverage so much. He is jumping up and down after that. He makes a great play, but thinking to himself, boy, I could have made a great interception there.
John Gold and Dominique Franks is back deep, one of the defensive backs, so you see from behind goal. Whistle prior to the snap. Now remember, there's only 4 yards here, but this is appeared to be against Texas. It is.
Offense, number 37, 5-yard penalty. It is still fourth down.
So after an explosive offensive start, the game begins to settle down here, and Gold will be punting. First punt of the afternoon for the Texans. Longhorns. Fair catch. And then lets it go into the end zone, so it'll come out on the 20-yard line. You know, Kirk, as you look around the landscape of college football, and I know that you and the gang have talked about this.
Yeah.
I think by far the best quarterbacks as a group are in the Big 12 Conference this year, and that's what makes this conference special.
You're absolutely right. I mean, you look at the top 10 in passing efficiency and scoring offense, it's mainly the teams from the Big 12. They've really made a statement to the entire country that I know the SEC always gets most of the credit and the love, but the Big 12, because of the offense and the quarterback play, has definitely closed the gap in some people's minds, maybe become the best conference.
Bradford has all time in the world. He can't get anybody open. One receiver went out of bounds and then stepped back in. Now, that is very intelligent by Bradford. Iglesias was stepping out of bounds, and instead of throwing the ball to him, he took off himself, because obviously that would have been a penalty if he'd had touched the ball first. Watch Iglesias work the sideline now. Steps right there as Bradford turns, and Bradford moving the other way, completes it on the run, and ball comes free, and it's ruled incomplete. Let me check that Broyles. So then he was down, obviously, on that play over there.
Sets up a big third down here early in this game. Again, I mentioned it in the last series. I know they gave up a touchdown in the first drive, but Texas's defense is coming after Oklahoma, something we've not seen from any defense yet this year.
Again, the one defense that got in his face mask a little bit in the second quarter, I was watching it. TCU got on him a little bit, but you're right. For the most part, no one has been able to exert extreme pressure on Bradford. There's obviously a whistle. Kendall was coming free.
It's delay of game here.
Delay of game.
So after the offense for Stoops shows a very impressive opening drive, they bogged down a little bit here.
Yeah, and I think I have to give all the credit to Texas and Will Muschamp here and the adjustments that they're making and the aggressiveness that they're playing with. Here's Bradford making the adjustments, looking over for confirmation from Cale Gundy, the running back coach, and a number of other assistant coaches on the sideline there. Texas also making their adjustments. A little cat and mouse game here on third down.
On the scramble, out of bounds, short of that first down indicator.
The key, as I said at the beginning of this game, could Texas get after Sam Bradford, get him out of his comfort zone, get him out of his rhythm in these last two series? That's exactly what they've been able to do, and Will Muschamp is fired up. When you can get pressure with four, when you have Arakpo up there and also number two, Sergio Kendall, applying the pressure, that makes it a lot easier to cover all those receivers.
Remember, there was extreme pressure exerted on Knoll's first punt. This time, everybody drops back. Cosby runs up. Let's go down below to Lisa. He was born fired up, that fella. Here's McCoy going deep, one-on-one, incomplete. Justin Tucker. And that was the coverage by Jackson.
Yeah, Brian Jackson. And Bob Stoops has talked all year about the secondary from Oklahoma playing well. He gets back in great position there and gets up, finds the football, most importantly, and is able to knock that ball away from Williams, who has great size, but good coverage on the boundary there by Brian Jackson.
Yeah, let me correct myself. That was the other nine, Malcolm Williams and not Justin Tucker. And obviously as the wide receiver. So second down and 10. McCoy's in trouble and going to get thrown down by Jeremy Beal.
These officials are coming together to talk about whether or not they're going to throw the late flag here. Beal comes in. Beal has such tremendous ability and speed here. Colt McCoy taking a chance to try to get to the outside. He gives him a little shake, thinking he can get by him. But this is Oklahoma. And this is an Oklahoma defensive end that can run. And they call the intentional grounding. And he obviously loses a lot of yards. But that speed up front, Colt has got to be able to have an awareness of how quickly they're closing in on him.
The Sooner muscle in that defensive line is starting to exert itself. Inside shuttle pass, Obanaya against that rush. Fine call by the coordinator. Lewis makes the stop. When you got him stomping and breathing just to pick up a few yards and then get the punting team out of the field. Final seconds of the opening quarter.
Pretty good defenses here in the first quarter. You know, after Oklahoma made the adjustments, or after Texas made the adjustments for that first touchdown, you know Oklahoma can run.
Ryan Broyles now on the field to return this goal punt. And he signals for the fair catch at the 26-yard line, and that's where they'll put it in play. Well, let's remind everybody, the NASCAR Sprint Cup Series, Bank of America 500 in Charlotte on ABC tonight. Under the lights in Charlotte, this will be a good one, folks. Carl Edwards, Greg Biffle, Dale Earnhardt Jr., Jeff Gordon, all look to bounce back after getting caught up in that big one at Talladega last week. Jimmy Johnson, can he do it again? Can he three-peat? Tune in tonight, 7 Eastern on ABC. First and 10. Folks, the left tackle for Oklahoma. Watch big load hold over there when you get a chance. As Bradford moves back to the right, he's going to pull it down frequently. There's great work by the secondary as the seconds tick away here in the first quarter. Bradford taking off far more than he normally does. Back after this message and a word from our ABC stations. Well, the theme of the State Fair of Texas this year is Ignite Your Senses. You buy coupons there, Kirk, and you buy yourself a fried banana split, and I tell you, that will ignite your senses.
Among other things, right?
The remodeled Cotton Bowl, and they did a fine job. Now holds about 92,000. Ticket sales split evenly. Here's Bradford, pump fake, trying to get down the near sideline, and he does, to an open receiver that time, and that is Ryan Broyles, the redshirt freshman from Norman.
little bit of play action here. They get Texas got pressure again on Sam Bradford, but it was just a well-designed play. You can see right there the safety, Earl Thomas, comes out thinking it's going to be a flanker screen, and it left a big opening there for Broyles.
Bradford not taking much time, and he completes another one to Broyles.
That's the big difference this year with Oklahoma. When they get first downs, they're up at the line of scrimmage, and they're attacking the defense. And the whole reason Kevin Wilson has decided to do this, number one, he has a quarterback that understands how to do it, but put the pressure on the defense and put them on their heels.
Rolling back to the left for a first down, and it is Broyles who has caught three consecutive passes, and you can see that coaching staff roll it up tempo.
Yep.
Let's move it as fast as we can on this drive.
And when you go up tempo again, it makes the defense lose some of their aggressiveness, which Texas has done a good job of here these last few series.
Fast break on grass, and here it comes on the move. You can't blink. They'll get another snap off Murray, and he gets to the 25-yard line for a first down. McElroy making the stop.
All it takes is one first down on the beginning of the drive, and it allows them to get this high-octane offense going. And you hear that term a lot. It's a fast break on grass, basketball on grass. And right now, that's what Oklahoma's been able to get back to. We saw this on the first drive.
Murray spins and goes down for a two-yard loss in the arms of Arakpo, number 98. There's a great battle going on up front with Lodeholt and Arakpo.
How about Lodeholt? 6'8", 335 pounds, going up against a very determined Brian Arakpo.
Second and 11. Breaking free is Iglesias.
Again, all of a sudden, there's rhythm. There's an ability by Bradford now to have time to throw, but it's crossing routes. It's running the football. It's dumping it underneath the Broyles. A lot of different looks. Now they're coming out in an empty set, making Texas think.
First and goal and not hesitating. Moving the pocket right and left. Receive juggle. Caught in the end zone on a ricochet. Touchdown. Broyles caught it. Broyles caught the ricochet from Jermaine Grisham. You'll see it.
Coming right at you. Grisham is all along. The safety Thomas comes up to make the hit. And the football just falls right into the hands of Ryan Broyles for a touchdown. And Brent, Grisham never had possession, so this was going to be an incompletion. And Broyles just does, with the fingertips, hold the football up off the ground for the touchdown.
Coach, let's put that one in the playbook.
Right.
Instant replay. We'll take a look at this one. They might have missed one earlier on Oklahoma's first touchdown. This appears to be a touchdown that the ball does not, although it was close, wasn't it, when he reached down?
It sure was.
So we'll take that one angle right here. Now, take a look at this and see if the ball does skim the top of the grass.
No, that's a touchdown.
There's daylight, folks.
That was a great look right there. Always better to be safe than sorry, as we learned in that first touchdown.
Yes, indeed. Right man in the right spot.
Royals had a big start to the season against the University of Cincinnati, where he had seven catches for 141 yards. He had Broyles to Iglesias and Manuel Johnson and Grisham. Four really talented targets for Sam Bradford. Former OU quarterback Josh Heupel, the quarterback coach, talking with Bradford along with Bob Stoops.
Jimmy Stevens back on. It is 14-3. Up tempo. Wow. A lovely, lovely day in Dallas. 14-3. Sooners lead the Longhorns. Moreland, the ball on the tee for the Sooners. return from the 5-yard line is Shipley. Big hole. Shipley. End zone ahead, folks. Touchdown, Longhorns. There is one flaw with this Oklahoma team, and it is their special teams. His eighth touchdown overall of the season, 96 yards. Hunter Lawrence. Tacks on the extra point. Game on in Big D. Pull up a chair, folks. This one's going to get real interesting.
College football on ABC, brought to you by Best Buy, you happier. Nissan, passionate about performance and proud sponsor of the Heisman Trophy. And Aflac, ask about it at work.
3 million in attendance expected here to the State Fair of Texas, which will extend on into mid-October. Started back earlier this month. And interested bystanders. It's about time us rascals got one in the end zone down there. He said, Mr. Shipley, with his first kickoff return ever for a touchdown, and Bebo enjoyed that very much. This is going to be returned from the 12-yard line. Iglesias. And ball was taken out of his hands as he was going down, I believe. And let's go back to
be
the
careful.
TD.
Well, let's go back to the play. And special teams in these kind of games typically mean so much. Look at the wedge right in the middle. And what a great job here by Obanaya and also Eddie Jones picking up the block. And then for Shipley, it's just a matter of hitting that crease and then beating the kicker with tremendous quickness. But it was all set up by a nice job there by the wedge, it creating a seam for Shipley to hit.
Inside handoff to Murray, stopped at the line of scrimmage. And let's take a look at our Pacific Life game summary. We want to show you the two quarterbacks because, of course, we're going to be focusing on them all day long. You can see that Bradford has the upper hand, but the better roommate award right now goes to the Texas quarterback.
No doubt. The big difference is the rushing yards and the touchdowns. Those are the two things that right now are the difference between the quarterbacks.
Fake the end around, roll the pocket out, hit Murray in underneath. And he's a yard short of that first down marker, McElroy.
Same exact
play.
Sorry, Brent. The same exact play that allowed Murray to pick up a big gain early in this game where he came out, snuck out into the flat off of the fake reverse, and went down the sidelines for about 35 yards. Texas
timeout is called by the defense.
Enough of that high octane offense. We need to get a timeout. Catch our breath.
Muschamp, of course, was the defensive coordinator at Auburn last year. And time for our Aflac trivia question. Yeah, the duck says, okay, Kirk.
You got me last week with the mistake.
What is Mac Brown's connection to Oklahoma?
I know
gave
that.
You a layup this
I
week.
Know that.
Gave
man.
You a layup.
I know that.
Don't give it away.
Okay.
There might be a couple people out there who don't know the answer.
Okay. I'll give you the decade. Is that a good hint?
That's good. There's Mac, his wife Sally, over in the booth right next to us. Of course, they were up at Colorado last week, and Sally was out hiking and broke her arm. Arm's in a cast, but she's recovering nicely. They're rooting for the Longhorns. Matt Clapp and now Chris Brown in that backfield on a third and one. They check with Kevin Wilson to see what he wants to do. Brown behind the fullback. Big crease for the first down. Let's go to Matt Weiner in New York, Matt.
Hey.
I'm Matt, and here Bradford on the play action is sacked for the first time, and he's brought down by you-know-who, folks. There is a great defensive lineman. That, of course, Brian Arakpo, the senior from Houston.
He's finally healthy, and we're seeing what a healthy Arakpo can do. There's the matchup we talked about, lone hole with the size, but not the lateral quickness, and Arakpo goes with an inside move, and what speed to get upfield and get after Bradford.
Yeah, there's a 300-plus pounder who didn't move his feet. Second and 19 as a result. Drop in that middle screen underneath Emmanuel Johnson. He is ridden down by Deion Beasley.
This offense picks up chunks of yardage so quickly. Little jailbreak screen. We've seen Johnson have a lot of success with that play specifically, picking up huge yards, and all of a sudden, second long moves to third and short.
Stands tall in the pocket, has all day, and wide open is Gresham. Headed in zone. Touchdown, Sooners. How about that for a downfield tight end? That's 52 yards.
Well, this is broken coverage by Texas. You see the young safety that time, Earl Thomas, jumping up on the underneath route, and they lost focus on Grisham. Broken coverage all alone, and then the big fella shows the speed to get to the end zone. That's sometimes the casualty of having two freshman safeties in the lineup for the Texas Longhorns.
Jimmy Stevens adds the extra point. Didn't take him long to get it back, did it? And looks like we've got a penalty flag down there by the line of scrimmage. So, tax on the extra point and then the penalty. Double whammy for the Longhorns, huh? We'll be right back. State Fair of Texas. Not everybody's on the inside, huh? And here it's 21-10, and how about Sam Bradford? Three touchdown passes here today for number 14. Watch this offense, and you really ask yourself, can anybody slow these guys up? He's 14 of 16 for 210 yards, and those three scores were mentioned.
Just when it looked like Texas was defensively containing Bradford, putting pressure on Bradford, a couple series later, he put those numbers up.
And
wow.
That penalty, of course, yeah. Takes Shipley out of it. They'll be kicking it off from the 45-yard line. You would think this would be a touchback. So much for that, and back we'll go to the TD.
Well, Emmanuel Johnson is on the outside, moving to the inside. And when he does that, what you're going to see is the big fella right here. He's going to move to the corner. The confusion by Texas comes from the backfield, the defensive backfield. Right there, the safety jumps up. And by doing that, also the linebacker comes up. Now you've got three guys covering Emmanuel Johnson and a tight end who maybe is the best target Oklahoma has, all by himself in the back part of that secondary. A mental error there for the Longhorns.
First down handoff. John Childs back on the field, the backup quarterback. All right. Affleck trivia time. Tell us about Mack Brown, his connection to OU.
I'm going to go back to 1984, I believe, where Mack Brown was coaching for the Sooners and working with a backup quarterback by the name of Troy Aikman.
Exactly. There's the staff. Headman, Barry Switzer. Pay attention to the cable boss time, Mac.
Come on, Pat. Boy, those teams in the 80s. Talk about high octane. Oklahoma, they would put 80 on you in a hurry.
He was there only 1 year. Penalty flag is thrown on the play. Pass is complete, but again, there is a penalty.
A free play there. Like Oklahoma, Clayton getting a little ahead of himself on the blitz.
Offside. Defense number 22. 5-yard penalty. Repeat second down.
During breaks, we keep talking about how important it is for Mac Brown's offense to come up with big plays to get the big kickoff return. But now this offense, pinned back deep in their own territory, they've got to come up with a drive. They've got to come up with points against this Oklahoma defense because the Sooners are scoring right now at will offensively.
It's Kirkendall in motion, number 11. Another punt penalty.
Horns may have given this one back. Oh. Movement on both sides.
Prior to the snap, offside. Defense, number 96. With the 5-yard penalty, first down.
Marcus Granger back in playing after missing a couple games with an injury. A little anxious on that side of the football right now. Here's Granger.
Obanaya thrown for a loss by that defense, and Travis Lewis, the redshirt freshman from San Antonio, makes the stop.
This is one of these Oklahoma defenses that you've got to be able to run right at them or throw the football right at them. If you try to bounce it against this speed we see now from these linebackers, Travis Lewis on one side, Keenan Clayton on the other, and Ryan Reynolds right in the middle, they move too well. I'm talking about 4.5 and 4.440 speed from these outside linebackers.
Second and 11, completes it to his roommate, and he gets across the first down mark. Jordan Shipley, he has the horns touchdown on that kickoff return.
Quarterbacks and receivers that are roommates always seem to be in sync, don't they?
Mm-hmm.
Hours and hours of coaches aren't around, other teammates aren't around in May and June and July, and you just throw day after day, and you get into a very comfortable rhythm, and you can see Colt McCoy and Jordan Shipley definitely have that.
Bluff on the blitz. McCoy snaps it off short, goes back to Shipley. Dominique Franks, the corner, the defender for OU.
That's a nice job there by Greg Davis. Again, going with a look that they haven't shown a lot of this year. Four wide receivers. They put Shipley right in the slot. They forced Oklahoma to go with a safety in the middle of the field. When you do that, there are a lot of openings in that zone defense from this Sooner defense. And give Colt McCoy credit for finding those holes.
Quarterback draw. Back to the line of scrimmage and no more after that because of Lewis. As you look at the Oklahoma team in the flesh, Kirk, I think you would agree this team is built for speed. This is a lean, mean football team.
You and I have seen a lot of these top teams that are up in the top five, top seven in the BCS. And athletically, Oklahoma doesn't take a back seat to anybody.
With that many athletes, I am really surprised that they don't defend kicks well. Complete down the sideline. He snapped it off to Cosby. The defensive back gambled that time. Jackson couldn't get to the ball.
Boy, Jackson a couple times here coming close to making big plays for the Sooners defense. Colt McCoy going back to the boundary. This is a tight throw. You've got to throw it away from the defender. Not only a great throw, but also amazing concentration here by Quan Cosby to be able to bring in the football and then turn upfield to pick up a first down.
First and 10 at the Sooners 35. Open to the left. McCoy, a good runner, will take off. And that should leave him in second and short.
That's what Colt McCoy has been able to do for this Texas offense this year. When you account for 68% of your offense, it's creativity, it's imagination,
the ability to improvise. And there's the balance so far. And they've not been able to obviously get their running game going. And, Brent, I think that was everybody's concern. With Colt McCoy as your leading rusher, how can Texas run the football against this athletic Oklahoma defense?
Obanaya is off to his right on second and one. Obanaya will try to stretch the defense. Not going to get there. Terrific defense. English stretched the play out, and then Jackson was able to come up and make the tackle. But credit English for making Obanaya run wide on this play.
Bounced into the outside, and then as much as we want to give credit to Quan Cosby for his ability to make a catch, he has got to do a much better job there of sustaining his block on Brian Jackson. Jackson got inside of him and made an easy play there in the open field.
Third and two. Throw for it as the run game bogs down. He does just that. Hits Cosby for the first down and more.
Wow. What a great job by Colt McCoy. This is a tight window. You've got eight defenders from Oklahoma dropping, many of which went right to the first down marker, and they all had their head on a swivel. He had about five Oklahoma defenders at about the four-yard mark trying to find a receiver to take away. They were there, but the accuracy for McCoy is the difference.
We'll see if they throw on first and goal immediately and not wait. Yeah, they're going to throw on first down. This will be second and goal from just across the three-yard line. Cosby again. But I think this is so revealing about the Texas running game, or lack thereof, when you come up and start firing on first down out of the shotgun when you've got a first and goal.
Well said, Brent. And you got to wonder, now inside the five-yard line, can Texas continue to have success throwing these tight, small windows now, because it gets so much tighter with such little room to work with against this defense.
Move the pocket to the right. Shipley's on that side. They throw in underneath, down at the one-yard line.
It was a great play call. Moving the pocket away from the pressure. Oklahoma came after him. And if Colt McCoy gets this ball up a little bit to Shipley, he walks into the end zone. So the matchup and the call, perfect. It was just a matter of execution there and a rare misfire, even though he completed it. A rare misfire by Colt McCoy.
All right, Jumbo is on for the horns. This will be the Jumbo look. You remember Loki and those guys? Well, it'll be Miller. Heel set in front of Johnson. Obanaya is off to the left. This is their Jumbo look. Third and goal. Johnson behind Miller, going to the corner. Stretches for the pylon. Touchdown.
Again, we saw the return, and then this time the big fella Cody Johnson, nimble feet, looked like he may have stepped out of bounds, but the nimble feet there to get the ball across for a touchdown.
Lawrence tacks on the point. A 12 play, 80-yard drive. Consuming 6:42. Texas' best drive of this game so far by far. ...21-17 as the horns respond again, Kirk.
Well, I mentioned it looked like he may have stepped out of bounds, but first watch the block by the big defensive tackle, Miller, who blows up. But right here, he steps out of bounds, but the ball looks like it crosses the plane before the foot steps out of bounds. You can see it get right there, get across, and then the right foot comes out of bounds for a touchdown for the horns. How about the big Miller, the big defensive tackle, getting in there and just bulldozing the Oklahoma defense?
Yeah, for a couple years it was Derek Lokey back there leading the way, and now it is Miller. Still, now the good news, Texas just scored. The bad news is Sam Bradford and this Oklahoma offense, they've got 3:41 left in the first half.
It's a lifetime.
They could have a couple possessions in 3:41. Texas and Colt McCoy showing a lot of guts on that drive.
From the yard deep, Murray. Middle return. And Brown brings him down. Let's head to New York. Matt Weiner for a Sports Center right now. First and 10 for the Sooners, coming out from their own 27. Inside handoff. Chris Brown back on the field after Murray returned the kickoff. Big Henry Melton with the snap.
We talked so much about Sam Bradford and his wide receivers. This offensive line has done a pretty good job here in this first half, too.
A lot of time. Drops it in underneath. And that time to Iglesias.
It's Texas defense flying around here. And where they get into trouble isn't necessarily in the first couple plays. It's after Sam Bradford picks up a first down.
Third and three. Roll pocket. Throw downfield. Intercepted on a beautiful grab at the 35-yard line by Earl Thomas.
How about the freshman's athletic ability and closing speed to be able to beat Broyles to the spot and then lay out and make an interception? He easily beats him there, but then he lays out. Great concentration, gets his body turned, but it was the pressure that forced Bradford to throw the ball. Look at Sergio Kendall from the backside, blowing up Sam Bradford and making him throw the ball before he wanted to.
Our first turnover. .246, Palmer shaking up on the play. Head on over. Coming up now on the Cooper Tire Halftime Report, John Craig and Doug will have highlights from today's early action. Not a lot going on right now, but as the day moves on, it's going to get busier and busier. And the guys here with the game day game, Chris, Lee, they'll take a look. And meanwhile, I'll take a break. Well, I have to pass that up till after the game.
Oh, you're beautiful.
I gotta tell you, folks, that
you're
was beautiful. First down and 10. Ball out of the 33-yard line, and here comes Colt McCoy. Show blitz, and they're coming. Couldn't get there. Got one-on-one, and a beautiful snare. Cosby grabs it. So the blitz backfires, and Texas is in business.
Right, you're dead on here. The linebackers come right up the middle. But what it does is it leaves Oklahoma's secondary one-on-one. The ball is thrown high. And how about Cosby adjusting to the football, going up and making the catch? It's the first time all year we've seen this Oklahoma secondary, especially the new corners, being challenged by an offense.
First and 10. McCoy forced to scramble this time. The defensive line for OU did a job, and he is thrown for a four-yard loss.
Ryan Reynolds getting involved there as well, and kind of the heart and soul of this defense, number 8, who's moved to the middle linebacker spot this year, this Oklahoma defense, and he's hobbling a bit. He's actually going to take a knee here. That is a not a good sign to see number 8 limping around out there, who's battled through a number of knee surgeries to come back and be healthy this year.
Have to see if he stays on the field. That was a third sack by the Sooners, and this one, nope. Colt scrambles out of trouble, now drops it off, incomplete, well out of the pocket over toward the sideline, and now there's a penalty clock. Is there a late hit over there by Lewis? Lewis was in pursuit.
Big.
Roughing
the passer, defense number 28.
Oh, that's huge, folks. This would have been third and long, and instead it'll give the Horns a first down. Take a look at this.
The emotion of the game, but I've got to be honest with you. That is a horrible call. And I'm a quarterback, and I like to protect quarterbacks. Awful call by the officials here protecting Colt McCoy. Lewis comes up and barely
it almost looks like
Colt
he was
McCoy.
Trying to hold him up.
That was a terrible call.
His hands, if it had happened over on Stoopsie's sideline, no penalty, folks.
Big break for Texas here.
Texas bench did a good job. First down ball at the 20-yard line now. Go back to the running game, that inside, whatever it is, Obanaya rushing Texas, because remember the sacks bring it off, so they've been held to minus 13, minus 3 total after that run by Obanaya. And OU's rush, though, for only 13. So. Yeah,
not that they needed to live and die by running the football tonight, but just the ability to show that you have it, because it can set up play action pass and try to slow down Oklahoma's defense. But what we've seen so far is not going to be good enough. Got to rely on Colt throwing.
Yeah, I'm sure he will here on second and 7. Try to rush 5. Don't get there. And he overthrew Collins. Just as well, because there are a couple of defenders over there lurking on that sideline, too.
The last series that Texas had, they went to a lot of the 4 wide receiver looks, and they found seams inside where the linebackers are lined up. I think here on 3rd down, I'd go back to that. Try to find an area where Cosby or Shipley could work into the inside where there's some space to work against those Oklahoma linebackers.
You know, without a tight end who has matured, you would think that Obanaya Kirk or one of the running backs would slip out also into a pattern here soon. Only 1 second left. Got it off in time on 3rd down. He drops it off to Obanaya. Oklahoma was ready. So this will bring the field goal unit out onto the field. Boy, through the last half decade, so many talented tight ends have been over there for the Longhorns in Austin, and now they've had injuries in the spring, and they just haven't had anybody mature in that spot.
You're exactly right. Blaine Irby going down in the Rice game really hurt this offense. They lost Josh Marshall, who was the second-string tight end. And that's why we're seeing so much 4 wide receiver sets today. If they're able to hit this field goal,
they're going to bring it on down so that Bradford doesn't get it back.
It's one of the better first halves that we've seen. They can make it 21-20 here.
Yeah. So we'll take a quick timeout, then we'll come back and see if the field goal is successful. So Hunter Lawrence will attempt a 33-yard field goal, our last play of the first half, attempting to make this a 1-point game and setting up what should be a fine second half here in Dallas. Shipley puts it down on the spin. We got a 1-pointer in the Cotton Bowl. Let's go down to Lisa.
Thanks a lot, Brent. Coach, you guys, Texas wasn't really able to do anything offensively until that big 80-yard drive. What changed defensively for you guys?
Nothing changed. They executed. Colt McCoy made some nice throws in some space. And then we had a bunch of penalties. We've had a bunch of offsides that have hurt and a personal foul on the quarterback.
Sam Bradford, just his 4th interception. What happened on that play?
Just going for a big play. Their defender made a nice play, made a diving catch.
All right, thanks a lot, Coach.
All right, and let's send it to New York. Big John Saunders, Craig James, and Doug Magic Flutie. It's the Cooper Tires Halftime Report.